Hello coding aliens, welcome back to my YouTube channel Code with a Key. Hope you are doing well. In this video we are gonna build an awesome project of 2021, an instant messaging application, that is Apple's iMessage clone. We are using React.js for the front end, Redux for all the state management, Material UI for all the icons, Google authentication for authenticating users, Firebase for all the backend stuff. Are you guys excited for this build? Hit the like button, and if you have any doubt regarding this tutorial in the end, do guys comment inside the comment section. I will reply each and every comment. I promise you all guys, I will give a reply or solve any doubt if you have regarding this tutorial at the very end of this build. Okay, so let's go to see the demo of this build first of all. So you can see here we have this very nice landing page here of the iMessage here. Simply click on this sign in button. Now I'm clicking the sign in. You will guys see here Google authentication. Now you have to simply give a account for which you have for which you guys are going to simply authenticate here. So simply click on this. I'm giving here last option here for this. Now you can see here we have after the, all this authentication, the pop-out is closed automatically, and we have this iMessage Apple's messaging application here. Now you guys can see here we have a bunch of chats here. Now you can see here we have a latest chat 18 minutes ago with Code with Aki. Now click on this chat. Now you can see here we have a very nice bunch of animation here, a React flip move app animation. So you guys will learn how we can add this add thing inside our build here. Now you can simply click on this any of this chat. Now you can see here all the chats popped out, all the messages popped out respective from that chats. Okay, we have a bunch of option to create a chat. Now click on this very at the top of this. Now you can simply have to pass a chat name here. So I'm giving a name here, YouTube tutorial. Okay, 2021. Click on the OK. Now you guys can see here we have this YouTube tutorial 2021 here that we have just now created this chat here. Now it's time to simply pass a message or simply send a message to this inside into this chat. So simply I'm going to here pass a message here. Let's build this awesome application. Click on the enter. Now you can see here the message is rendering on the chat screen, also in the right side and the left side. You can see here we have this message that is already populating on the sidebar section of the latest message here with the name, logo or the profile images of the respective user here. You can see here okay. Now you guys build this chatting application. It is a real-time instant messaging application. If you guys I will not passing any message, or I will not send any text here. I am going to simply use my mobile phone here to send a message to inside this YouTube tutorial on my mobile phone. When I hit the enter, now you guys see there will be a message here appeared here. Okay, so let's go and try this also here inside this build. I have already added a message here. Okay, I am going to simply hit the enter on my mobile phone. You guys will see a message will appear on the chat screen also in the right part of this. Now I have hit the enter here. Now you can see here I am excited for this build because I have this user. I have logged in with the another username here. Now you can see here we have the message from another Gmail account that of myself, that I have send the message directly from a mobile phone. Now you can see here this is a real-time instant chatting application that is built in React with the help of Redux, Material UI and the backend stuff for the Firebase here. So let's go back to the coding zone here, how we are going to build this application. So inside of Visual Studio Code you have to simply open the terminal here. Inside of the terminal, you have to simply fire the command npx create React app for generating the boilerplate React application for all the things that we are going to do here right now. So I'm going to simply back to my right directory first of all. Okay, so here I'm going to simply fire the command npx create React React app and the name of the project. So I'm going to simply give the name here iMessage clone. Okay, iMessage clone Aki. Okay, now you can see here we are using the Redux, so that's why it is bit different command that we are going to do here. So for the Redux, you guys have to simply add another two words here, that is a template Redux. Now you can see here the recommended way to start a new app with React and Redux. You can see here in the documentation of the Redux here. So basically you guys have to simply give in here the template. So basically we have, I'm going to give here the template and here Redux. So it will create a boilerplate React Redux application. So hit the enter button. It will take a couple of minutes here for installing the required dependencies that we are going to use here. Now you can okay, so we have used a capital here, so that's why it is throwing the error here. Okay, now hit the enter. Now let's go back. In the meantime, I'm going to simply set up my Firebase project. So Firebase here. So for the Firebase, you guys have to simply log into your Gmail account first of all, and you have to simply go to the URL console.firebase.google.com. Here you will thrown at this page here. Now click on this add project here. You guys have to simply give a project name here. So I'm giving the project name of iMessage clone. Okay, now click on the continue here. Click the continue one more time. Select the default Firebase here. Create a project here. Now you can see here the project is initializing in the inside our Firebase here. It will simply set up all your Firebase services that we are going to use here, of the Firebase features that we are going to implement in this build. So this will set up all the required stuff inside here. Now you guys can see it is finishing up here. So click on this continue. Now on clicking the continue, now we are using the Google authentication. So for that, you guys have to simply enable the authentication inside your project here. So let's go. First of all, you have to simply register the project. So for that thing, you have to simply click on this icon here, click on the web here, because we are going to create a web application. So that's why if we are clicking the web app here, now you have to simply give a name. So I'm giving a name of registering my app here. So that's why I'm giving a name here. If you guys want to deploy or host your project on the Firebase, simply check this option here. If you guys want to deploy your project directly on the Firebase, so that's why you have to simply enable the option or the check. Click on the checkbox here. Simply click on the next without worrying anything about that. Now you can see here we have this one app here. Now click on this setting icon here on the very down of this page. Now you can see here we have this config and we have this Firebase configuration that we are going to use inside our project. It will simply enable all the Firebase services if you are using any Firebase services, you have to simply add this Firebase config object inside your project prior to use any Firebase services. So I will do it later. Okay, so here I am going to simply set up the first of all the backend here for the Firestore here. So for all the real-time messaging, enabling the messaging here, so simply click on this Firestore, click on this create database. It is a very important step here. You guys have to simply click on the test mode. It will allow all the users to read and write requests in that particular database for the 30 days. After 30 days, it will automatically denied or denied read and any update inside the database. If you guys want more days, or you guys want to simply add more days for this, so you guys have to simply delete this stuff or simply erase this line from the rules section. So after that, you will use that database time that you are that you will use here. So simply click on this, click on the enable here. Now you can see here it is provisioning all the Cloudflare store. That's it is simply, it will simply set up the backend for the database here. It will simply set up all the databases features that we are going to use here. Okay, so it is provisioning the cloud store. Okay, you can see here it is setting up the security rules. If you guys want to change the security rules, you have options to simply edit the rules inside the rules tab. Okay, now you can see here the project is installing all the dependencies inside this directory iMessage clone Aki. Okay, so we have successfully initialized, or we have successfully created our Cloud Firestore here. Now it's time to simply enable the authentication. So click on this authentication tab here. Now you can see simply get started here. Now we have a bunch of options from the different providers for the authentication. We have this email password, we have this phone, we have the Google Play games, GitHub, Yahoo, Twitter, Facebook, Apple. So in this build we are going to use a Google authentication, so that's why click on this toggle button here. So for enabling the Google authentication provider here, click on the save. It will simply shut up your Google authentication inside your project build. So it will take some time. Now you can see here it Google enabled here. Now we have successfully initialized our Firebase project or configured the Firebase stuff inside our build. Now it's time to do a real coding here. So prior for the real coding here, so I will request all you guys, or recommend all you guys, to watch my previous Telegram clone that is already created a couple of days ago. You guys have to simply go to the description, or you guys simply find this video on my channel page, or I will simply throw the link of that clone inside the description. So the Telegram clone is also created using Redux. If you guys find hard to digest the Redux stuff, it is highly recommended to all you guys to simply watch all the part second of the Telegram clone that we have created. It covers all the Redux Nike concepts, so you guys got each and every thing of the Redux from creating a state to dispatching all the information from that states inside this that tutorial. So you guys, if you guys have any doubt regarding that that build or inside of this build, do comment, or you guys simply join my Telegram channel and Instagram. You guys simply get all the updates from this channel on the Instagram or in the Telegram for the next build. So all the links you guys will got in the description here. So here you can see it is simply installing all the dependencies here. Now you guys can see we have successfully installed all the dependencies here. Now it's time to simply test the project, the required dependencies that we have created here. So simply copy this thing here, copy this and paste it down here to go to that directory here. So simply click on this. Now simply fire the command here, npm start. It will start the React application inside your browser that you guys can simply debug from there. So now I'm clicking this npm start. Now it will simply start the project inside your browser. From there you can simply debug this. Now you guys can see here on successful compilation, all each and every thing here, you guys will get this a nice logo of React here, and we have this state already created here. So simply on clicking the add amount here, now you can see here it is simply incremented here. You can simply add asynchronization here. Now you can see here. So we are good to go from here. Now it's time to simply do all the coding stuff here. So I'm going to simply open the folder here. So I'm going to simply open the folder where we are inside this build. So simply select, I have selected the folder here. Now it's time to do all this stuff, all the stuff here. So inside there, now you guys can see we have this source directory, or inside this source directory we have the bunch of test files. So first of all, I will delete all the test file here because we are not going to do any testing here. So I'm going to simply delete the test setup here. So app.test here, logo here also. Okay, so I'm going to simply delete all these things here. So simply delete here. Okay, fine. Now you guys can see we have this feature, and inside this feature we have this counter. So I will take care of this thing later when we will do the Redux stuff. So simply in this build, I'm going to simply show you the all the front end first of all, then we will go to the Redux stuff. Okay, so that's why we are going to simply do here. So simply click on this app.js. Inside this app.js, grab all the header section here, delete all the header section first of all here. Okay, now here inside of this, let's get rid of this thing first of all here, make it a bit smaller. Okay, now here import logo, first of all get rid of this thing first of all, delete this, we have nothing like this thing like here. Now simply get rid of this counter statement also here. Okay, so we have this React Redux. Now it's here for the testing. I'm going to simply give a here name, hello from code with a key YT channel. Okay, now save this, open the terminal here. So simply click Control J here, open the terminal here. Refresh this, you will see it will throw an error because I have closed the directory here, so that's why. Okay, get cross this, and now here simply fire the command npm start. So simply start the fresh Redux React Redux project here. So npm start, simply click the fire the command npm start here. Okay, now you guys can see here we have this hello from code with the QYT channel. Now you can see it is centrally aligned here. So for this, you go back, go to your app.css, grab each and everything, delete this, shape this, go back to the index.css. Now you can see here we have all these things here. Okay, so here for removing all the browser enabled features, so that's why I'm going to simply give a margin of 0 or padding of 0 here. So that's why I'm going to simply give a margin and padding for each and every page a 0 here. So it will simply neglect all the browser default feature here. So margin and the padding is 0. Now save this. Okay, so now we are good to go from here. Now in go back to your app.js. okay, so inside this here, so inside this app.js, I'm going to simply build here. Now you can see we have a chat screen here. We have a chat screen here. Inside this, we have this sidebar section. We have this sidebar chats here. We have bunch of options here. We have this header section. We have this icons. So first of all, to get these icons, just like this, this search box icon, search icon here, and the mic icon here. So basically, to get all the icons here, so for this, I'm going to simply install the dependencies for the material UI. So for this dependency, you guys have to simply go to your terminal here, fire the command npm install @ material UI code. So first of all, to use any material UI things, you have to simply install the code first of all. So that's why I've given the fire the command here, npm material I material. I have wrongly spelled the material here, so that's why. Let's delete this first of all. Inside another terminal here, fire the command here, npm I, and then name of the dependencies here. So npm I average material material UI code. Fine. So it will install all the material UI dependencies inside your project build. After that, we will install the material UI icons to get all these icons inside our build. So pay attention here. The meantime of installing all the dependencies here, I'm going to do the other stuff here. So get rid of this hard coded text first of all here. So now you can see here we have a container, just like a container of iMessage here. So I'm going to simply create a component first of all inside here. So I'm going to simply create a component here. So I'm going to simply add another folder in the name of components. So inside of this, we have all the components here. So inside this component, I'm going to simply create a file with the name of iMessage .js for here, and corresponding CSS file for styling this component. So I'm going to simply create add another, rename this. So iMessage.css, fine. So inside this iMessage.js, I'm going to simply use. Now you can see here inside the terminal, we have successfully installed the material UI code. Now it's time to simply install the icons here. So here, instead of the code, you guys have to simply give here the icons here. Now hit the enter button. Now it will install the icons here. So here inside of this iMessages, I will create a functional React functional component inside the React by firing simple word here, RFCE, not RFCE, for React functional export component. Hit the enter button. Now you can see here we have a boilerplate React functional component here. You guys all get these things from the my here. Now you can see here this marketplace. Search for the ES7 React Redux GraphQL snippets. You will get this nice snippets here. So I'm obeying the bin convention for inside this build for simplicity here. So I'm giving the name, class name here, iMessage here. So here I'm giving a hard coded text here, hello from iMessage, for all the testing purposes here. So that's why here I'm going to simply import the iMessage first of all here. So import iMessage, import iMessage dot CSS. Just like this. Fine. iMessage dot CSS. Now save this. Go back to your app.js for rendering this thing. So I'm going to simply go back to this app.js. Now I'm going to simply call this component inside here for rendering here. So simply click on this iMessage. Now you can see here it is automatically imported from the components iMessage here. So simply close this tag here. Now you can see here we have this. Let's save this first of all here. Now go back to your deployed project here. Now you can see here we have this hello from the iMessage here is rendering on the screen from here, that we have given the name that we have already given a hard coded text here. So inside this iMessage, now you guys can see we have this container. Inside this container we have another two component container, and now you can see here we have this is we have the left inside to our left here we have this sidebar chats, and we have this message container. So first of all, I will create this sidebar chat component first of all here. So for this, let's go back to your iMessage.js, get rid of this hard text here. So here I'm going to simply, first of all, I'm going to simply create a component first of all inside this component. So I'm going to simply create a component here. So basically we have a sidebar. So we have this sidebar component. So sidebar .js. We have this sidebar component, and for this styling sidebar js, I'm giving the another, I'm creating another file, css file for styling this. So we have this sidebar js and we have this sidebar css. Okay so inside this sidebar js, now you guys can see here. Okay, so I'm going to simply generate our boilerplate functional component. First of all, here obeying the BEM convention, here I'm giving the class name here sidebar. So sidebar, that's why. Okay, so fine, here I am giving for the testing, so hello from sidebar is here. Import the CSS file first of all. So import sidebar.css, sidebar.css. okay, now save this. Okay, so when I save this, how we will render this? So go back to your imessage.js. here you guys have to simply give a name of sidebar here. So sidebar here, so hit the enter button. Now you can see here it is auto imported from here. So sidebar.sidebar. So basically we have auto imported the sidebar component inside here. Now save this. Now you can see there will be a sidebar, hello from the sidebar. So we are good to go from here. Now go here inside of this sidebar, get rid of this hard coded text. Okay, go back to your deployed version, previous deployed version. We have this sidebar, we have already created this sidebar. Now inside this sidebar we have a number of sidebar chats also here. So for this thing, I will first create this sidebar here. So after that we will do all these things for the sidebar chats here. So basically inside here, okay, now you can see here we have already installed the npm, we have already installed all the dependencies for the material core for all the icons here. So that's why we have created these things. Now collapse this. Now you guys can see here we have this avatar. So basically we will use avatar here. So it's time to simply import the avatar. Okay, so I will auto import this thing, so I'm not going to do any hard coded text here. So sorry, so we have this sidebar, and inside this sidebar we have this header option here. So I'm going to simply create another div here, div class name. So we have this header, so sidebar header. Okay, close this div here. So inside this sidebar header we have this avatar, we have this input field here with the icon, and we have this add a chat icon here also. So basically we have a bunch of things. So we have this avatar. Okay, import it from here. So now hit the enter button. Now you can see here we have auto imported the avatar here. So we have this avatar. Okay, now we have this sidebar input. So I'm giving a wrapping inside another class name here. So class name sidebar, sidebar input. Close this div here. So okay, so inside this sidebar sidebar input we have an input field here. So we have an input field with a search icon. So we have an input field here. Okay, now you can see we have this input field and we have this search icon. So I'm going to simply use the search icon here. So search icon, I'm going to simply import it from the material UI icons here. So simply import search icon from @material_ui/icons/search. Search, got this. Okay, so we have this search icon here. For styling this search icon, I'm giving it a class name here. So simply I'm giving the class name of search icon here. So class name here, sidebar search icon, got it. Okay, so fine, we have this search side icon and we have this input field. Inside of this input field we have a placeholder with the name of search here. So I'm giving a placeholder here. So placeholder, for the placeholder, now you can see we have this search, search search. Okay, fine, so we have this placeholder. It will take a type of text here. Okay, fine. Now save this. Go back to your default okay deployed project here. Okay, Control Z this. Okay, now you can see here it is compiling, so that's why it is not showing. Okay, now you can see here it is compiling here. Okay, so let it compile first. You will see we have this search icon, we have the avatar, and we have the input field here already rendering on the screen here. So now you can see here it is compiled here, successfully compiled here. Now you can see inside the project inside through the left side right side of the screen here, inside the browser here, we have this icon for the avatar, we have this search icon, we have this search input field here. Okay, so we have created the header section here. Now it's time to okay, we have this add chat icon or add chat icon also here. So here I'm going to simply add this first of all. So after this div of for the header, inside this div of this header, we have this icon here. So for this I will wrap it inside a icon button. Now you can see here on clicking we have a nice ripple effect here. So simply I'm going to simply cancel this. Okay, so we have a very nice UI for this. So I'm simply wrap it inside a icon button here. So wrap it inside this icon button. Okay, so we have this icon button. Let's close this. Okay, I have imported it from the Material UI course, so that's why it is showing at the very top of this. Okay, so inside this icon button, we have an icon which is called Ret Review. Okay, Ret Review outlined icon. So this is the things that we are going to use here. So Ret Review outlined here. Now you can see at the very top of this we have this Ret Review icons here. Okay, fine. Now save this. You will see the icon will populate on the screen also here. So we have this Ret Review icon here. Fine. Here I'm giving a class name here for all the styling purposes for this. So I'm giving a class name here. So class name here, sidebar input button, sidebar input button. Okay, I'm giving the variant here. So variant outlined. Got this? Okay, fine. Now save this. Okay, it is compiling here, so that's why it is not rendering on the screen. Let it compile first of all, then you will see all the things here. Okay, so fine. We have created these things here. Sidebar, we have already created this sidebar header section. Now it's time to simply create all the chats here, sidebar chats here. So we have this sidebar chats here. So after this div, I'm going to simply add another div with the class name of sidebar chats here for all these chats here. Now you can see here it is another component inside a component. Okay, so I'm going to simply create another component with the name of sidebar chat, and I will simply render it here. So basically I'm going to simply create a sidebar chat component here. So sidebar chat, just like this. Okay, go back to the project directory here. Okay, create another file here with the name of sidebar chat. So basically we have this sidebar chat .js and corresponding CSS file for styling this sidebar chat. So we have this sidebar chat .css, just like this. Okay, so go back to let's close, collapse this first of all. Okay, so we have this sidebar chat .js and we have this sidebar. So inside this sidebar chat, first of all you guys have to simply import this sidebar chat. So at the very top of this here, I'm going to simply import the sidebar chat first of all. So simply import sidebar chat from sidebar chat, just like this. Okay, now shape this. Go back to your sidebar chat here. I'm going to simply give RFCE, hit the enter button. Okay, R F C E, hit the enter button. Okay, I think I don't know why it is not you R F C E. Okay, so we have this functional component here. Now obeying the main convention here, so simply give a class name here, sidebar chat, just like this, sidebar chat, just like this here. Okay, so I'm giving a hard-coded message here. This is sidebar chat, so if everything will find, it will render on the screen just like this. This is sidebar chat. Now save this. Okay, go back to your deployed version here. Now refresh this. Now you can see here we have this icon. Okay, now you can see here we have this icon and a very nice ripple effect. So that's why I have wrapped it inside the icon button for all the nice UI hover effect. Now you can see here on clicking this. Okay, so we have this sidebar chat here. Now it's time to simply create a sidebar chat, a hard-coded sidebar chat. We have this avatar here. We have the name of the chat here and the latest message and the timestamp here. So basically, how we are going to do this. So first of all, let's get rid of this hard-coded sidebar chat here. First of all, here inside there. Okay, so now, okay, like this. Okay, so we have this sidebar chat. So inside of this sidebar chat, we guys going to simply add an avatar here. So we have this avatar, so I'm giving avatar. So simply import it from the material UI core. So that's why I have created this sidebar avatar. So we have this avatar here, so simply import the avatar first of all. So hit the enter button. Now you can see here avatar is auto imported from the material UI core. Okay, fine. So inside of this sidebar chat, okay, so we have this avatar, we have the name of the chat here. So I'm going to simply wrap it inside h3 tag here. So simply h3 inside of this h3, we have this sidebar chat, simply name of the chat, just like this. So simply I'm giving a name, chat name, simply give a name just like the chat name. Okay, we have this message, we will have the message here. So okay, so I'm going to simply wrap it inside information, another div, so it will be easy for us to simply give a styling here. So simply I'm going to wrap it inside sidebar chat info. So sidebar chat info, just like this. Got it? Now fine. I'm going to simply do this. Okay, so inside this chat name, we have a p tag which contains the message. This is message, just like this. Got it? Okay, fine. Now next, you can see here we have this timestamp also here. So we have this timestamp inside. I will wrap it inside a small tag, just like this. We have this timestamp. Got it? Now fine. Okay, so we have this timestamp, basically timestamp here. Okay, fine. Now save this. You will see all the things is will rendering on the screen here. Now we have this avatar, we have this chat name, we have this message, and we have this timestamp. So we have created this successfully created the sidebar chat here. Now it's time to do some styling first of all. So how we are going to simply do all the styling here? So it's now you can see we are using the flex box here. We have a flex box for the left and the flex box for the right. We have this flex box for the sidebar chat, and we have the flex box for the flex box for this message section here. So let's go first of all to the imessage.js here. We have this imessage.css. so prior to do any styling or doing the any CSS stuff here, I'm going to simply add some styling to the app.css first of all here. So here, okay, we have simply okay, so inside this app.js we have this iMessage. Okay, so we have this iMessage. So I'm going to simply style the iMessage.css first of all. So we will use a flex box or the display flex of here inside this iMessage.css. So here now you can see we have this iMessage.css here. Okay, so inside this iMessage.css we have a name of the class with the name of iMessage, just like this here. So basically we have this name here. So I'm giving a display of flex. So that's why we will use a flexbox CSS here. So we have given here the display of flex here. Okay, now it's time to go to your sidebar. Okay, let's go to sidebar dot CSS. So we have this sidebar chat, so I'm going to simply replace it from here. Okay, so inside this sidebar CSS we have this sidebar header first of all. So here inside this sidebar dot CSS we have a bunch of class names for the styling that we will do inside this sidebar dot CSS. First of all, I will simply style the sidebar class here. So simply I'm giving the sidebar class a flex of 0.3 that will use a 30% that will use 30% or 35. I'm giving the flex of 35, so that will use 35% of the entire width of the screen here. So I'm giving the flex of 35 here. Height, a minimum height of 100 view height. Okay, now I'm giving the flex direction of column, so that all the things will be go back to the column here. So I think I'm going to simply add it. Okay, put it here. Okay, so I'm going to simply import the sidebar.css. okay, I have already imported the sidebar.css here. Okay, fine. So go back to here, sidebar.css. okay, so we have this flex direction of column, and I'm giving the background color. So background color, I'm giving the background color for the nice little grayish color here. So background of this here. Now save this. Now you can see here background is changed here a bit of a little light gray here. I'm giving a border right. So border right here. So border left right. Okay, now so border right of 1 pixel, solid light grays. So light gray. Okay, light gray, just like this. Now save this, and you will see a sidebar border here. Now you can see here border right here. Now fine, let's go here. We have the sidebar header. Now you can see we have this sidebar header. So I simply style the sidebar here. So I'm going to simply use the sidebar. We have this sidebar header just like this. Okay, okay, and let me cross check this. We have this sidebar. Okay, now we have this sidebar header. So simply install the sidebar header first of all here. So sidebar header, I'm giving the display of flex. It will simply arrange each and everything inside a row here. Sidebar display of flex here. Okay, align items. I will simply align all the items centrally, and giving the padding of 10 pixel from everywhere. Okay, I'm giving the height of 50 pixel. So height of 50 pixel, just like this. Okay, just like this. Now save this. Now you can see here it is simply shifted from the 10 pixel from there. So we have this sidebar here. Now it's time to simply style the sidebar avatar. So we have this sidebar avatar here. So for the sidebar avatar, we have simply I'm giving the cursor of pointer for the nice clickable UI here, and margin of 10 pixel from everywhere. Now save this. You will see it will now simply move a bit right here. Now okay, it is not rendering because okay, now I'm giving a class name here. Simply give a class name of here. So we have this sidebar, avatar here, like just like this here. Okay, now save this. You will see okay fine. Simply style the sidebar avatar. Now it's time to simply style the sidebar input. So simply sidebar, we have this sidebar, and inside this sidebar input we have this sidebar input. For this I'm giving the display of flex. Okay, not inline. I'm giving the display of flex for arranging all the items in a row first of all here. So we have this display of flex. Align items centrally. So align item center, and justify content center. Now save this. You will see all each and everything will be centrally aligned here. Okay, I will give a flex of 1 that it will use as much width as it is required here. So that's why I will give the display of I will give the flex of 1 here. I will give a background color. So background color, I've given the background color of the nice grayish color here. So background here. Now we have this background. Now it's time to give a color of the text. So I'm giving the color of text of the gray, and given the border, border, I'm given the border radius of the nice rounded border here. So simply I'm giving the border radius of 33 for the nice rounded border. Okay, now you can see here, and the height, given the height of the 40 pixel width for this. Now you can see here we have this height here. Okay, so now it's time to simply target the input field here, because you can see a weird outline and the margin here. So we have this inside of this sidebar input, and we have this inside of the sidebar input, we have this input just like this. Okay, so simply I will target the input here. So we have this input. Okay, so inside of this input I will give a border. We have this border, so I will give the border of none. Now you can see here, we have nothing on the border here. I will give a background color. So simply background will be a transparent. So for the nice UI, so simply give it the background color of the transparent. Now you can see a transparent border here, and outline width. So simply I'm giving the outline width of zero, just like this. And okay, so here now you can see. Okay, now save this. Okay, now you can see here. We are done with this. Now it's time to simply style the icons, search icon here. So I'm giving the sidebar, we have this sidebar input, and inside this we have this sidebar search icon. So for sidebar search, okay, now let me cross check it one more time. We have this sidebar search icon just like this. Okay, fine. Now inside of this sidebar.css we have this sidebar search icon just like this. Okay, here for the sidebar search icon I will give the color of nice apple color here. So the color is 3E9 3FD. Okay, now save this. You will see a color of the search icon is turned here. Okay, so we have this sidebar search icon. So we have simply styled the header here. Okay, so now it's time to simply style the sidebar chats here. So simply we have a simple sidebar chat. So basically we will have a bunch of chats here. Now okay, now you can see here we have a single sidebar chat here. If we grab it and replicate it a bunch of time here, you will see, save this. Now you will see we have a bunch of sidebar chat name just like this. So we have a bunch of sidebar, so we have a bunch of chat name here. So that's why we will have a scrolling feature here. So I will not give a browser default as scrolling. So I will simply do a smart scrolling for a nice UI. So that's why I will simply select the sidebar chats. So basically we have a sidebar chats just like this here. So we have this sidebar chats. Okay, so I will simply give a overflow. So if we will have overflow, I will simply give a overflow of a scroll, and I will simply want to vanish the scroll button. So for this I will simply select the following things here just like this here. So we have this sidebar chats. So for this sidebar chats I will simply do the webkit scroll bar display of none for the browser just like Safari or the Chrome. For this, if you are using the Internet Explorer or the Opera Mini or the Mozilla Firefox, so for this I will do a sidebar chats. So we have this sidebar and inside this sidebar chat we have this MS overflow. So we have this MS overflow style. I will give it simply a none. Okay, and the scroll bar width here. So simply a scroll bar width here, scroll bar width. Okay, let me do one more size. So scroll bar width is 0 here. Now save this. Okay, it will simply vanishes all the scroll bar from the screen, but the functionality or the feature of the scroll bar is still applicable. Okay, so we have simply done with this. Now it's time to simply style the sidebar chat here. So simply go to the sidebar chat dot css here. So inside here sidebar chat, so simply select the sidebar chat class name first of all. So we have this sidebar chat class name, or inside this we have this avatar. So we have, for this avatar, what we are going to do, simply we will style the sidebar chat here. So now you can see here we have the hair icon here now, and we have this things here. So simply I will give a display of flex for rendering all each and everything in row. First of all, so I will simply give a display of flex and save this. Now you can see here it will go in a row here. Okay, display of flex. Let's go back here. Okay, so we have this sidebar chat and we have this sidebar chat information. So SIDEBS sidebar chat. Okay, so it is not rendering because of we have not imported the CSS. First of all, simply import the sidebar.css here. Now save this. You will see it will simply go by row here. Okay, so inside here we have this sidebar chat here. Okay, fine. Okay, I think it is still compiling, so that's why it is not showing. Okay, it is compiled successfully at the very top. Now you can see, okay, now it is compiled. Okay, so we have this sidebar chat, we have this sidebar chat here, and we will give a display of flex here. So okay, you can see here we have imported the wrong file here. So we have this sidebar chat.css. Now save this. Okay, now go back to here, sidebar chat here. So now you can see here it is go row by row here. Now it's time to simply style the things here. So we have this sidebar chat. I will simply align all the items to a center first of all here, and we will give the padding of 20 pixel from everywhere. So now you can see it will be a nice padded up here. Now you can see it is now nicely padded up here. Okay, I will give a border bottom for simply styling or simply distinguish it from the other sidebar chat. So that's why I will give the border bottom of the solid light gray, just like this, light gray, light gray. Now save this. Okay, so we have this border with a sidebar light gray here, and we will give a cursor of pointer for nice clickable UI. Okay, now you can see here we have this cursor of pointer here. Okay, so fine. Now we will simply style the hover effect here. So we have the sidebar chat, and now we will give the hover effect. For the hover, I will simply change the background color for a nice apple background. So that's why we will use 3E93FD for nice nice color of the apple here. Okay, so now we have this color of white. Now you can see here it on hovering, it will simply change all the colors here. Okay, so we have simply created this. Now we have to simply we have option sidebar chat option information, sorry, we have this sidebar chat information. So that's why I will simply select the information just like this. Okay, so inside of this I will give the margin left of 15 pixel, just like this. So simply it will simply slightly get shifted 15 pixel here. So margin left of 15 pixel. I will give a position of relative because we will use a position of absolute for the timestamp. So that's why I will give the position of relative here. So here I will give the position of relative and the width of 100% here. Okay, now we have the sidebar chat information. Now it's time to simply style the timestamp here. So that's why I will simply select the following things here. So we have this sidebar chat info. Inside of this we have a small tag for the timestamp here. So we have this small tag. I will give a position of relative, so that will be simply relative with the sidebar chat info here. So I will give a bottom, so I will give a bottom of minus 18 pixels, so that it will simply shifted to the bottom here. I will give the right of 0, so that's why it will simply right aligned here. Now you can see here it will, the timestamp will go to the right here. Okay, now we have this things here. Now let's go. We have simply styled each and everything we have simply styled the things here inside to of our sidebar here. Now it's time to simply style the right section here. Now you can see we have a very nice chat box here. So for this I will simply go and create a bunch of components here. So here we have a message here, just like this. Now you can see here we have this message here, and inside of this message we have a message options here, and we have at the very bottom of this we have a very nice input field for sending the message here. So I'm going to simply create a component for the for these things also. So simply I'm going to create a component with the message.js. So we have this message.js, and we have this corresponding CSS file for the message. So we have this message.js and message.css here. So in this build, okay, inside of this message.js I will simply create a functional component first of all. So how we will create the functional component, you guys have to simply fire the command, fire a little word here. So rfce, it will simply generate a functional component here, obeying the when convention here. So that's why I will give the name of the class here with the message, and inside of this I will give simple things. So for this I will simply give a message just like this. This is message for the, all the testing purposes. For that's why I will give a hard coded text for this. So simply import the message.css file first of all. So message.css here. So basically we have this message and we have this message here. So like this. Now save this. Go back to your iMessage. So go back to your iMessage. So here we have this iMessage, and now you guys have to simply render the things here. So simply I will render the message section just like this. It here. Now you guys have to simply import this. Simply import it. So I'm going to simply import it from the here. Now it is auto imported here. Now save this. Go back to your deployed here. Now you can see there will be a message. This is a message now rendering on the screen. So we are now good to go here. So how we will do, or we will simply create all these contents here. So go back to your message.js. So simply I will message.js here. So inside of this message.js, inside of this message.js, get rid of this hard coded text here. This is message like this. Okay, so inside of this message.js you can see here. Now you can see here we have this avatar, and we have the name, we have the chat, and we have the timestamp here. So how we will do this? So simply we have, you can see here we have this avatar here. So I will simply create an avatar just like this. So I will simply import it from the material UI code first of all. So simply import it from the code here. So we have this avatar. Okay, so I will give a class name for the avatar for styling these things here. So we have this class name here. So simply give the class name of message photo. Okay, it is a self closing tag. So simply I will simply close this, and it will just like this. Now we have this avatar, and we have a p tag for the message here. So we have a p tag for this is message just like this. Okay, so now after this we will have a timestamp. So for this we will have this a small tag for the timestamp. So this is a timestamp just like this. Okay, so now save this. You will see, go back to your deployed project, and now you can, okay, unterminated JSX syntax. Okay, we have not closed the p tag here, so that's why it has thrown the error here. Okay, so we have this avatar, we have this is message, and we have this timestamp here. So now it's time to simply go and simply style the iMessage. So here you can see here we have a header section here. Now you can see here we have this header section here at the top, very top of here, and we have this avatar. We have styled it in another way. When you will send the message, all the message will be going in, go into the right side here, and when the other user will when the other user throw the message, the message will be go to the left align, and the background for the message is the light grayish color. And if you guys send the message, then your message will have a background color of the nice apple color here. Now you can see here just like this. So I will do it inside here. I will do it here. So okay, later in the CSS part, so we have simply created a message portion here. So we have done with this message portion here. Now it's time to simply style the top section for the message here. So we have a chat box here, or we have the chat screen here. So for that thing, I am going to simply create another component. I will simply save this first of all here. I'm going to simply create another component inside here. So we have the chat here. So basically we have this chat.js. okay, not ss, simply I will simply rename this first of all. Okay, so simply rename this chat.js, got it? Okay, so for this we have the corresponding chat.css file for styling. So we have this chat.css. okay, so let's go here inside of this chat.js. Here I will simply create a nice snippets for the functional component here, obeying the when convention. So simply give a class name here, so class name of chat. Okay, so inside of this chat we have a chat header. Now you can see we will have a chat header here. So here we have this chat header here. So I will simply wrap it inside another div here. So I will give a class name. So class name here of chat header, just like this. Let's close this div first of all here. So close this div. Okay, so inside of this chat header. Okay, so inside of this chat header, now you can see we have a statement, or we have a word written just like a two here. So I will simply wrap it inside a h4 tag here. So h4 tag for wrapping the two. So I will simply wrap it inside a h4 tag. So we have this two, and after this we have the name of the chat. So basically I will simply wrap it inside a span. So simply I will wrap it inside a span here. So simply span, give a span here. Okay, so we have this chat name here. So we have this chat name just like this. Okay, I will simply give a class name here. So I will simply give a class name here. So class name, so I will give a class name of chat channel name, or the chat name. Okay, so we have this class name. I have given the name here. So chat name here. Okay, so we have this chat name here inside of this span. And after this we have a details section just like this. So after this h4 tag, I am going to simply add another strong tag, or inside this strong we have this detail just like this. Okay, so details. So it is just like inside the iMessage for the Apple. If you guys have using the Apple messaging application, you guys will get these things exactly these things inside the Apple messaging app. So that's why we have added this detail section here. Now after these details, I am going to simply add another div and simply wrap the message inside this client div. So simply we have this chat messages. So that's why I will give in a div here. So for this we have this chat message. So wrap it inside a class name with the chat message, or inside this we have a messages component that we have already created. So I will simply auto import it from the source component here. So we have this message. Okay, so now we have this message. Okay, now fine, we have this message, and after that we have this chat bottom, and inside the bottom of this we have a input field, and we have this mic icon here at the bottom of this. So I'm going to simply wrap it inside another div here. So I will simply wrap it inside another div. So div class name, and inside of this we have this chat input, and inside of this simply close this div here. So inside of this chat input, we have this form. So form will simply do form will be very helpful when we have to fire an event here. So simply on clicking the enter button, the form will simply submit, auto submit here. So simply I will simply wrap it inside of form. We have this input, and inside of this input I will do a bunch of things here. So we have this input, we will have the value for the input. So we will have value for the input. So I will simply add the value later when we will do fire a message. So I will do the value for the letter here. So we will have this value. Okay, we will have the placeholder here. So for the placeholder, I will give a placeholder here. I message just like this. So simply enter the message here. So we have this placeholder. There will be a type of text here just like this. Okay, now we will have the button, and the button will be disabled, or the will not be shown here. So how you guys can do this feature here. So we will have the button name button with the name of send message just like this. Now you can see here we doesn't have any button just like this. So we have simply given the visibility of none for the button, but all the features for the button is still applicable here. So that's why we will do it in the we will do these things inside our CSS part. So that's why we have this button with the send message. Now save this. You guys go back to here. Now you can see there will be, okay, I think it is compiling, so that's why it is not rendering here. Okay, make it much more bigger here. Now you can see it is compiling here. Okay, now save, refresh this. Okay, so we got this because in go back to your iMessage. So simply I'm going to simply back to my iMessage here. So when you go back to your iMessage.js, you can see we have simply rendering the message here. So I will simply render the message instead of this message. I want to simply render the chat. So that's why I have to simply render the chat here. So let's auto import the chat first of all. Okay, now get rid of this message first of all here. So get rid of this message. Okay, now save this. You will see all the things will rendering on the screen with the chat here. So now you can see we have this chat name, we have this detail, we have this very nice avatar here, we have this message, we have this timestamp, we have this send button, and we have this input field here. Okay, so let's go back to your chat.js here. Now here we have this input here. Now it's time to simply add a mic here. So we have this mic here. So after this form, we will have this mic. So that's why I'm going to simply wrap it inside an icon button. So it will have a very nice UI effect. So that's why I'm going to simply wrap it inside an I button. So inside of this I button, I will use a mic icon from the Material UI course. So that's why we have this mic icon. So we have this mic none just like this. Okay, simply import it from the Material UI icons. Hit the enter button here. So simply auto import it. So hit here. Okay, click on the these things here. Now you can see here it is auto imported at the very top of here. Okay, so now save this. You can see here there will be a mic with a nice ripple effect here for the nice UI here. Now it's time to simply I'm going to simply give a class name here. So for the styling, so that's why I'm giving the class name. So mic none, and giving the class name of chat mic just like this. Okay, now save this. Go back to your chat.css. so first of all import the CSS file for the chat here. So after that we will do all the styling here. So we have this chat.css just like we have this chat.css. okay, now save this. go back to your chat.css. Now it's time to simply style all these things. So simply we have this chat. Okay, so inside of this chat, I am going to simply give a display of flex. So display of flex, it will simply throw each and everything inside to a row. Now you can see we have this everything inside of this, just like in a row. I will give a flex direction, so flex direction of column, just like this. Okay, so we have this flex direction of column. Now save this. You can see each and everything will go in a column here. Okay, I am going to simply give a flex of 0.65 for the remaining of the screen here. So that's why I'm giving a flex of here 0.5, and the height of 100 view height for entire height of the screen. So I've given the width of here, and then I'm going to simply give the background color. So background color of white. Okay, so we have given the background color of the white. Now next we have the chat header. So simply add the chat header, or simply style the chat header here. So we have this chat header. I will give the padding of 20 pixels from everywhere. Display of flex. Okay, now we have this display of flex and justify content. I will simply justify the content here. So now you can see here we have these things here, and we have this detail here. So for this, I'm going to simply give the justify content of a space between. So now it will give a very nice space between these two things here. So that's why I will give the justify content here. So justify content space between. Got it? So we have this justify content space between, and I will give a border bottom. So border bottom of 1 pixel. solid light gray. Okay, now save this. Now you can see we have a very nice border, border bottom here, and I'm going to simply give a background color. So okay, background color, for the background color I will give a very nice grayish color here. So f5 just like this. Now save this. Now you can see a very nice background color. Okay, now it's time to simply style the chat message, or the simply style the two. Now you can see we have to simply style the h4 tag. So we have this chat header, or inside this chat header we have a h4 tag. And for this h4 tag, I will simply give a color of here, color of gray. Gray, just like this. Now save this. Okay, and give the font weight. Okay, now the font weight of 500 here. So font weight of 500 here. Now you can see here it will have now simply done with this. Now it's time to simply style the timestamp here. So that's why I will simply style the timestamp here. So we have this chat header, or inside of this we have this strong, no, we have to simply, I'm going to simply style the details here. So simply we are inside of this small strong, we, I'm going to simply change the color of here. So color will be a very nice apple color. So 3E93FD, it is a color of the apple here. Now you can see here the color is changed here, a bit of tincture of sky blue. Okay, so we have done with this. Now it's time to simply style the messages here. So simply we have this chat messages. So that's why I will give the flex of 1. It will simply go all the way down, push each and everything after this to all the way down at the bottom here. So flex of 1 will do these things here. So I will give the flex of 1. We have this chat message here. Let me cross check this one more time. So we have this chat message, not messages. So I'm going to simply make this message just like this. Now save this. You will see things of this will go at the bottom here. Okay, so flex of 1 will do these things here, and I will give the overflow of a scroll, because we will have a bunch of messaging, and I will not going to and I'm going to simply add the overflow of a scroll here, but we will not want any scrolling feature here. Okay, so that's for that, for these things. We will go, we will simply display the we will simply remove or vanishes out the out these things here. So tab, scrolling tab here. So how can we do this? So it simply for this I am going to simply remove this just like this. So here I will simply select the WebKit scroll bar here. So we have this WebKit scroll bar, and inside of this I will simply give a display of flat, display of none. So it will simply not showing you any scrolling tab here, but the functionality of the scrolling will remain enable on the screen here. Okay, so this thing is for the Google Safari, Apple Safari and the Google Chrome. And if you are going to simply if you are using Microsoft Edge or the Internet Explorer, so for this you have to simply add MS Overflow style on the scroll bar. So scroll bar width, and it will simply not showing any scroll bar tab to any browser in this world. Okay, now we have this scroll bar width and the MS Overflow overflow style of now scene of this. So we have done with this sidebar messages. Now it's time to simply style the chat input here. So now it's time to simply style the input field here and the bottom of this. I will give the display of flex here, so it will simply throw each and everything inside in a row. Now you can see here we have this display of flex here, and I will simply align all the items centrally. So align items in center. Okay, so we have this align item center. I will give a padding here, so 10 pixel from the top and the 20 pixel from the left. So you can see here it is now shifted a bit here. Now I'm giving the border top here, so simply I will give the border top of 1 pixel, solid light gray. So this is the border of the top, and then I will simply change the background color here. So simply I will the background color of a very nice light grayish color here. Now save this. Now you can see the background color is changed and the border is now appearing on the screen here. So we have this input. Now it's time to simply style the form. So for the styling the form, so we have this chat input. Okay, now not chat message, we have this chat input, but inside of this input we have this form. So simply for the form I will give a flex of 1. It will simply use as much space as it can, so that's why I've given the flex of 1 here for the form here. So we have this form, and after that we inside of this form we have this chat input. So inside of this chat input we have this form, and inside of this form we have this input field. So for the input field I will give the width of 90%, so that that will stretch to the 90% of the 90% of the screen relative to the parent here. So that's why we have given the width of 90% and the outline width of 0, just like this. And I will give the border of 1 pixel solid, and the color will be light gray. So very light grayish color here, border here. And now I will give the padding of 5 pixel. So padding will be the 5 pixel. Now you can see here we have a very nice thing. So now it's time to simply style the button, or simply we want to remove the button. Okay, so we want to simply vanish the button, but the functionality of button will remain here inside here. So that's why we will simply use a display of none feature here. So I will do in like this. So we have this chat input, we have this form, inside of this form we have this button. So simply we have this button, and for the button I will simply give the display of none. Now you can see the button will be vanishes, but the functionality of the button will remain applicable here. Okay, so we have done with this. Now we have created all these things here. Now it's time to simply give a border. Okay, so now you can see here for the input field I will give a very rounded border. So for this I will simply give the border radius. So simply give the border radius of 33 pixels, just like this. Now you can see very nice rounded rounded button or the rounded border of the input field here. Now, so we are done with this. Now it's time to simply style the message part here. So simply go back to the message.css. Inside of this message.css, we have a bunch of things to do here. So here, so for this, we have this message.css. So for this message.css, what we are going to do, we have to simply style the avatar, we have to simply style the message and the timestamp here. So for this, I will simply select the message class here first of all, and we will give the display of flex. So it will simply simply throw each and everything in a row here. Okay, so we have this message.css, get these things here. We have this message.js, so display of flex. I will simply align all the items centrally. So simply align all the items center, and I will give the position of relative, because we will use the position of absolute for the timestamp. So that's why we are using the position relative here. I will simply give the width of fit content. Okay, so it will not simply it will not squashes away the message here. So that's why we have given the width of fit content. And I'm going to simply give the margin right. So margin of 10 pixel, not right, margin of 10 pixel from everywhere. So margin of 10 pixel from everywhere. Now save this. You can see here. Now you will see very nice things here. Now it's time to simply style the message here. So simply I will simply style the message. So for the message, inside of this message, I will simply style the p tag here for the message here. So I'm going to simply give a background color for this. So we have giving the background color a very nice gray color. So f3 ff, just like this, f3 very nice background for this message here. And I will give the font size of medium. Okay, now I will give the padding, and the padding of the 15 pixel. Now I will give the border radius of 20 pixel, just like this. Okay, fine. Now give the margin of 10 pixel. Now save this. You can see a very nice border and the rounded things here now appear on the screen. I will give the margin right of auto, so that's why it will simply aligned line to the left of this. So that's why we have given the margin right of auto, so it will simply aligned to the left side of the div here. So okay, now it's time to simply style the timestamp here. So that's why I'm going to simply select the small tag here. So we have this message, and inside of this message we have this small. Okay, so now we have this color of gray, very nice color, not gay, it's color of gray. Okay, I will give the position of absolute, so I will simply style it with respect to the message here. So that's why we have given the position of absolute here. Okay, and I'm giving the font size here a very small font size of 8 pixels. So now you can see here it will be a font size of 8 pixel here. Okay, so color of gray, I think that's why it is not showing here. Okay, now we have this message, and inside of the message we have this small tag. Okay, now the color of black, now you can see, save this, it is not showing. It is showing here on the very top. Now you can see here on the top of the very top of the avatar here. So that's why the things is happening here. So this happening here. Now it's time to go here back. We have this colored gray, just like this. Okay, so I we have given the font size of the 8 pixel. I'm going to simply give a right of 0, so that's why it will simply right aligned. So that's why we have given the right of 8. Okay, and the bottom of minus of 5 pixels, so that's why it will simply shifted to the bottom here. So we have this bottom of, now you can see here the timestamp is going at the very bottom of here. Okay, so we have done with this. Now we I'm going to simply do we are done with this. Now it's time to, okay, so go back to your the build here. Now you can see here we have these things and we have these things. So we are done with the UI of we have done with the UI. Now it's time to simply do all the Redux stuff here. So are you guys excited for the Redux? So we have created all the front end here. Now it's time to do our Redux stuff here. So first of all, we will do the authentication part here, and later we will do the Redux here. So how we are how we guys will proceed from here. So first of all, first step here is that you guys have to simply go back to your directory here, or okay, inside of this source, you guys have to simply create another file with the name of firebase.js. okay, or inside of this firebase.js, you guys have to simply do the this thing. Go to your firebase project here, and here now you can go to your project setting here. So go back to the project setting here. So inside of this project setting, we have this config. So we have already talked about this config section here. So simply grab this, copy these things here, and paste it down here. So we have this Firebase config here. So okay, so inside of this project, we are going to use the Firebase as a backend stuff. So how we are how we guys going to implement these things here? So for this, you guys have to simply install the Firebase inside your project directory. So how you guys going to simply install the Firebase? So open the terminal here. So inside of this terminal, you guys have to simply fire the command npm I Firebase for installing the Firebase inside your project. So I'm going to simply install the Firebase inside of my project. So I'm going to simply fire the command npm I Firebase just like this. Now it will simply simply install the Firebase inside your project directory. So simply hit the enter button. Now it will take a couple of minutes, and it will simply install the Firebase dependency inside your project directory. Okay, so now you guys can see here we have successfully installed the Firebase inside our project directory. Now it's time to simply install the Firebase at the very top of this Firebase, inside the Firebase file, at the very top of the Firebase file here. So okay, get rid of this comment section here first of all. Okay, so here I'm going to simply import Firebase from Firebase just like this. Okay, now so we have installed the already installed the dependency of the Firebase here. So okay, inside the Firebase config, so we are going to simply initialize the Firebase app. So I'm going to simply do here, so create an object here, so Firebase app, and here we have this Firebase dot initialize app, or inside of this you have to simply pass this object here. So copy this, paste it down inside here. So here you have to simply initialize the Firebase app here. So now we are going to use the database here. So we will go and create a object for the database here. So we have this Firebase app dot firestore, okay, firestore function. Okay, we will do the authorization. So that's why I'm going to simply create an auth object here. So we have this Firebase, so Firebase dot auth for the function for the authorization. Okay, now we are going to use the Google authorization. So that's why we are going to use create a provider object here. So inside of this provider, we have a new Google auth provider. Okay, just like this. Okay, and now we will simply export the each and everything here, so we can use these things inside outside this file also. So export auth and provider like this, and export the default DB. okay, just like this. Now save this. On saving, now save this. Okay, So now you can see we have successfully initialized our Firebase and installed the Firebase inside our project. Now it's time to go and simply create a Redux or simply do the Redux stuff here. So how we can do the Redux things here. So basically, let's go to the features here. So inside of this feature, we have this counter. So how we guys get rid of this? So simply, I'm going to simply grab this counter slice outside of this here. Okay, so now inside of this, we have these two things here. So counter module.css and the counter.js. So for this, I'm going to simply delete both of this. So both of this counter and this counter.css. Okay, delete this and delete the counter. And delete the counter also here. So I'm going to simply delete the counter also here. So delete the counter here. Okay, fine. And grab this thing, counter slice, and put it inside the features here like this. Okay, so we have this counter slice, or inside of this counter slice, we are going to simply okay, so I'm going to doing the Firebase Redux stuff here. So you guys have to pay attention or simply get each things here. Or simply understand the concept of the Redux here. First of all, so first of all, I'm going to simply create a user slice for the authentication. So that's why we are going to do the following things here. So for the user slice, I recommend all you guys to simply rename this thing. So I'm going to simply rename this counter, rename the counter slice like a user slice, just like this. Okay, so we have this user slice. Okay, so instead of this create slice, okay, now it is fine, just like this. Okay, so we have this user slice. So here